Nigel Ferguson's back with me today from AVZ Minerals. Nigel, good to see you.
Thanks very much.
Tell us a bit more what's been happening as far as your financing. You've got a significant new shareholder.
Yes, finally, Yibin Tianyi have managed to submit their application. So we're very pleased to have them on board, 9% shareholder. And there's some good things happening in the background with their hydroxide build and plant in China.
Tell us a bit more about them then. So they're looking to become one of the big hydroxide suppliers in China, are they?
They are, yes. They're currently constructing a 25,000 ton per annum hydroxide plant. The project director and myself have visited that, and they were well advanced obviously before COVID-19 breakdowns, but they were well advanced in finalising that first plant. And the idea is for an additional three trains to be put together, so they'll end up being 100,000 ton per annum producer, which is major in the scheme of things.
And will they be one of your off-takers as well? Is that the idea?
They certainly are, yes. They've got obviously a requirement for about 160 to 200,000 tonnes of SC6 for the first train that they're producing. And then we'll build it up from there, hopefully, as a mutual relationship builds together. And they might end up taking about 600,000 tonnes of SC6 from us.
It's worth a mention, one of their shareholders, CATL, they've got a 15% stake in that company. Who are they?
CATL, Contemporary Amperex Technologies. They're one of the largest battery manufacturers in the world. I think they're probably number one, number two in the world, I would think. Significant company, very strong balance sheet, and they seem to have fingers in lots of pies, including Yibin Tianyi, I think it's a 15% shareholder. It's big brother in the background.
And you've also been updating on your options. What's the latest?
We have an expiry date of May 24th for a set of options that were issued quite some time ago. I think they were 3 years old, or they will be 3 years old. 3 cent options, and we've got Canaccord Genuity to underwrite those options to the tune of, I think, 5.3 mil. We are expecting a lot of the shareholders to convert, so there might not be that much left over at the end of the day, but just to have that surety there at the end to make sure that we get the full 5.3 million.
So with the options and this placing here, your own balance sheet must be in fairly decent condition, is it?
It is, yes. With those two, plus the previous money we raised, the 3.6, we'll be sitting around about $19.6 million pre-costs. And then we've got a couple of significant payments that need to come out fairly soon. We will obviously repay the $1 million US convertible loan that came through from N Resources, which was part of the Yibin transaction. And then we have our final payment to Commonier, the state government parastatal, who own the project to start off with. So there's the final payment to them of $1 million. Still leaves a fair amount of money in the bank to get on with preliminary works on site.
And when you can get back out on site, what are you hoping to do? What are your plans?
Yes, that's the big if at the moment, isn't it? Look, we've got lots of work we can get on with. The first target will probably be what we call the wedge, which was that little piece of material, about 10 to 17 million tonnes that sits at the bottom of the pit. We couldn't get into a decent category last round of drilling, so we'll probably drill that out a little bit more. We have a planned 1,500 metre drilling program that will bring that up into indicated status and hence convert into reserves. We also have some geotechnical and hydro work that needs to be done, so that'll be done at the same time. And then the camp can be expanded a bit further to have the construction crews accommodated. Probably want to have some process water running around as well, so lots of things we can get on with.
Is there any idea as to when you might be able to get out there? I know you say it's the big if, but what needs to happen?
A flight would be good. I think we can actually get out of Western Australia at the moment. The issue would be Africa really hasn't taken off with COVID as yet. I think we're still waiting for that to happen. From what I'm hearing, people are talking about June, July as being the big month for them. our site, we haven't had anything as of today. Touch wood, we're hoping that that'll stay the same. But Congo, I think, somewhere around about 500 cases, maybe 22, 23 deaths. So it is there. We need to be careful. And, of course, it's a case of if you go there, you come back to Australia, you're going to be put into quarantine for 14 days, which is fine because we're separating anyway.
All right, Nigel, nice to see you. Thanks for the update.
Pleasure. Thank you very much.